Now we've finally taken that turn that leads us up into the high country. This particular loop starts out in the small town of Marysvale and heads up Bullion Canyon, past the Bullion Falls and the Miners Park, and then up past Hennessy Point. It goes above Timberline, and then it drops back down into Cottonwood Canyon and follows along Cottonwood Creek on its way back, once again, to the small town of Marysvale. This trail is one of the most popular of the trails in this area for the ATVers, as it's both scenic and mostly easy. And it covers such a wide range of country with plenty of opportunities for scenic outlooks. Notice that even now, in the very early fall, some of the aspens are already beginning to show their colors in the higher country. Now with that said, and this awesome scenery to look at, let me climb up on my environmental protection soapbox for just a minute. This area that we loosely call a Paiute ATV trail country encompasses somewhere near 7 million acres of public land. Let me repeat that, 7 million acres, not 70,000, not even 700,000, 7 million acres. And no matter where you look in any other state, you won't find such an available use of public lands by those of us that love motorized transportation. And trust me, that fact has not gone unnoticed by those that want to keep us from enjoying our country and using it for hunting, fishing, and exploring. I say this as a warning to everyone that uses these thousands of miles of trails here in Utah. What we have here is by far the greatest opportunity we could ever ask for showing those that want to shut us out of this land that we can indeed treat it responsibly. And it just seems so simple. Stay on the marked roads and trails. There are more trails here than you could possibly explore, even if you stopped working for the rest of your life and did nothing but explore them. And do not litter. In fact, if you see trash left by those that do not care, pack it out for all the rest of us. I know, for most of us, that sounds like such silly, simple rules, but it only takes a few idiots to ruin it for all of the rest of us. So until they have a season for idiots, let's just hope that we can keep them on the existing trails and their trash in their own rigs. This place is just too good to lose. Now, this is one of those areas in the trail that gives us, you know, a good outlook on what you got to be careful for anytime you're in Paiute trail country in central Utah because of the height. I mean, we've just come over a pass that was 11,000 feet once again, and we'll come down steep, steep winding canyon. And you can see here just how washed out this is. Some of the locals have said that the trail that we were on previously was just open 2 weeks ago. This shows signs that this was pretty majorly washed out. So once again, let this be a little bit of a lesson. When you're out in the wilds like this, you can follow these trails, but you know, keep an eye on the weather. Check ahead of time on what the weather's gonna be like so you know if it's gonna be monsoons or storms moving in, or if it's late in the year, if snowstorms are moving in. And keep an eye, because if there was a big storm, you could be trapped up here for days until they got it fixed, or you know, even longer, because there's no cell phone service. So you really be prepared when you go in, you know, pay particular attention to the weather, also pack accordingly. You know, I've always been a little bit of an overpacker on what I carry, but you better carry extra supplies and cold weather gear. This country right here is a perfect example of you can go from, you know, warm weather down at 5 or 6,000 feet to freezing weather at 11,000 feet with the wind blowing. So you really got to take all that into consideration when you're doing this trail, just because of the hazards of weather moving in, changing conditions, and changing the trail. So check ahead and go prepared. And as always, on any of these trails we're showing you, you need to always be on the lookout for wildlife, as this area is home to an abundance of deer and elk, with plenty of hawks and even golden eagles in the sky.
Now
here's another example of what I was talking about, how the road could get just wiped out with a storm. Because this, you can see, this is pretty freshly just torn away and then fixed. Just the way this has come down. We just watched some of the trees laying out on the side. And this tore up. Now, who knows about the culvert, but this area, you can see that it kept on going down this road. So if you were up here and there was a major storm brewing, a lot of times when you're up in this high country, it's those summer monsoons that move through that just tear this area up in no time. It's happened in the past, and you know, just another reason to be real prepared when you come up here. So I think we're getting pretty close right now to hitting to the main road in Marysvale, but I think also we're going to be following this Cottonwood Creek as we go down, so we may see some more spots like this. Like all the trails in this area, the Cottonwood Canyon Trail can change quickly from rocky to really rocky with just one passing storm. But then, that's one of the things that give these trails their character. You just never know for sure exactly what they're going to be like until you're there. That's the kind of stuff I like. Once again, our trails have found us back in Marysvale. When we do the loop from I-70, just outside of Richfield over, we ended in Marysvale, because it's a good stop to get supplies, get gas. Now, once again, we've headed up Bullion Creek, gone over the mountains that you see in the background, way up there, down Cottonwood Creek, Cottonwood Canyon, and back in here. Now, you could do these trails. Kind of the speed is determined by how much time you want to spend looking around. You can just breeze through them and do them in, say, half a day, or you can take your time and you can spend more than a day. But whatever you do, the roads are good enough to do in a decent four-wheel drive. Now, another thing to remember is Marysvale is a pretty good hub for leaving from. It's got supplies, good grocery store here to get the supplies, gas station that you can fuel up from. Also, if you wanted to use this as your home base, there's a couple motels here, hotels that you could come in, let's say, drive your pickup truck, have your ATVs on it, do some exploring in your four-wheel drive pickup truck, and then do some more exploring in your ATV. So it makes for a good place to leave here, especially if you've got family with you that doesn't want to camp. This would be a good place to start from, come back to. And it's right off of historic Route 89. So, hey, you know what? That's our show. I hope you enjoyed this adventure in Paiute ATV country in 4x4s. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week. Till then, God bless.